Freeze's kick returned by Gaunt. Tackle on the play made by Freeze. The star. 2 yard line. No axe pass to Axman is complete. Good for 3 yards. Tackle on the play by Kasperson. Noack's pass to Murphy is complete. Tackle on the play by Freeze. First and 10 for the Stars. Redner on the carry. Tackle on the play made by Grabowski. Loss of a yard on the play. He goes against Centura. We'll repeat, second down. He goes against Centura. It'll be second and 1 for the Stars. Redinger on the carry. Garcia on the tackle. First and 10 for Kearney Catholic. Noack's pass to Gaunt is complete. Tackle on the play by Malgoza. Gain of 4 yards on the play. Redinger on the carry. Tackle made by Hurt. No gain on the play. No X pass to Crone is complete. Tackle on the play by Fanta. Brings up fourth down. Carry. Kasperson on the tackle. Turnover on downs as a result of the play. The Centurions will take over. First and 10. Rules pass to Lindbergh is complete. Tackle on the play by Lowe, but not before. Centura first down. Fanta on the carry, Redinger on the tackle. Loss of a yard on the play. Rule on the keeper. Tackle on the play made by Rogers. 10-yard gain on the play. Morris on the hold, freeze on the kick is true. And with 5 minutes, 12 seconds remaining in the first quarter, your score is the Kearney Catholic Stars, 0. And your Centura Centurions, 7. and Freeze's kick bounces into the end zone for a touchback. The Stars will take over first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Redinger on the carry, tackle made by Grabowski. 6 yard gain on the play. And Trevino is dropped in the backfield by Boston Kasperson. Noack's pass to Murphy is complete. Tackle on the play by Freeze. First and 10 for the Stars. Noack's pass to Gunn is complete. Tackle on the play made by Fanta. First and 10 for Kearney Catholic. And Noack is dropped in the backfield by Bladen Garcia. Noack's pass to O'Brien is complete. Tackled in the backfield by Morris. Third and 20 is the result for the Stars. Noack's pass to Gunn is complete. Tackle on the play by Melgoza. Flag on the play. Holding goes against Kearney Catholic. We'll repeat, third down. Noack's pass intended for Lowe falls incomplete. Coverage on the play by Lindbergh brings up 4th and 33. Hamilton's punt returned by Morris. Tackle on the play by O'Brien. The Centurions will start out first and 10 from the 30-yard line. Morris on the carry, Murphy on the tackle. 5-yard gain on the play. Morris on the carry, O'Brien on the tackle, but now before us, Centura first down. And as the clock runs down to zero, your first quarter is complete with a score of the Kearney Catholic Stars, 0, and your Centura Centurions. Rule on the carry, Trevino on the tackle. 7 yard gain on the play. Centura has it, 2nd and 3. Morris on the carry, Holman on the tackle, but not before a Centura first down. Casperson on the carry, O'Brien on the tackle. 8 yard gain on the play. Morris on the carry, Trevino on the tackle, but not before a Centura first down. And it's Jacob Rule scampering in for a Centura touchdown. Morris on the hold, freeze on the kick is true, and with 9 minutes, 27 seconds remaining in the second, your score is the Kearney Catholic Stars 0, and your Centura Centurions 14. Reese's kick returned by Gump. Tackle on the play by Murphy. The Stars will start out first and 10. Trevino on the carry, tackle made by Morris. 1 yard gain on the play. Trevino on the carry, hurt on the tackle. The Stars will have it, 3rd and 8. Noack's pass intended for Gaunt falls incomplete. Brings up 4th down. And that's Blayton Garcia recovering the fumble. Centurions start out 1st and 10 from the 33-yard line of the Stars. Morris on the carry, Holman on the tackle. Face mask goes against the Stars, and that results in an automatic Centura 1st down. Rule on the pass intended for Freeze falls incomplete. 2nd and 10. the keeper, Murphy on the tackle. But not before a Centura first down. First and goal. Jacob Rule is in for another Centura touchdown. Morris on the hold, Freeze on the kick is good. With 7 minutes and 21 seconds remaining in the half, your score is the Kearney Catholic Stars 0 and your Centura Centurions 21. Freeze's kick returned by Gaunt. Tackle on the play by Hurt. The Stars will start out first and 10 from the 30-yard line. Noack's pass intended for Murphy falls incomplete. Coverage on the play by Lindberg and Fanta. Redinger on the carry, Melgoza on the tackle, flag on the play. Face mask goes against the stars. We'll repeat, second down. Redinger on the carry, Grabowski on the tackle. Third down for the Stars. Redinger on the carry, tackled by a host of Centurions, brings up fourth down. Nowak on the carry, Fanta on the tackle. Centura will take a timeout. That is their first timeout of the half, and they will have two remaining. And Centura starts out 1st and 10 from the 40-yard line of the Stars. Morris on the carry, Ragish on the tackle, 4-yard gain on the play. And Quentin Morris goes in for a Centura touchdown. Thank you. The point after is no good. So with 5 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in the half, your score is the Kearney Catholic Stars 0 and your Centura Centurions 27. Freeze on the kick, Gaunt on the return, tackle on the play by Mackey. The Stars will start out first and 10 from the 37-yard line. Trevino on the carry, tackle on the play by Garcia. Redinger on the carry, tackle by Melgoza. Noack's pass to Gaunt is incomplete. Flag on the play. Pass interference goes against the Centurions. It'll be an automatic first and 10 for Kearney Catholic. Trevino on the carry. Melgoza on the tackle for loss. Brings up second and 12 for the Stars. Nowak on the keeper, Kasperson on the tackle. Third and seven for the Stars. Noack's pass to Murphy is complete. Tackle on the play by Caden Rule. Flag on the play. Holding goes against the Stars. We'll repeat third down. Noack on the keeper, Morris on the tackle. Centura will take a timeout. That is their second timeout of the half, and they will have one remaining. Flag on the play. The result of the previous play is a safety. Your score with a minute 13 remaining in the half is the Kearney Catholic Stars 2 and your Centura Centurions 27. Freeze's kick returned by David. Tackle on the play by Murphy. The Stars will start out, 1st and 10. From the 37-yard line. And Nowak is taken down in the backfield by Mackey. Flag on the play. Yard face mask goes against the Centurions. It'll be 2nd and 1 for the Stars. 1st and 1 for the Stars. No axe pass intended for Edeal falls incomplete. Noack on the keeper, Hurd on the tackle. Kearney Catholic will take a timeout. That is their first timeout. They will have two remaining. Penalty goes against the Centurions. It'll be first and 10 for Kearney Catholic. No axe pass intended for Murphy falls incomplete. It'll be second and 10. A no-axe pass to Murphy is complete and good for a Kearney Catholic touchdown. And the PAT from Wings is good. With 27 seconds remaining in the half, your score is the Kearney Catholic Stars 8, 9, and your Centura Centurions 27.
Yeah.
Wings' his kick goes into the end zone for a touchback. The Centurions will start out 1st and 10 from the 20-yard line. Morris on the carry, tackled by a constellation of stars. Morris on the carry, tackle made by O'Hare. And the clock will wind down to zero with your score at halftime. The Kearney Catholic Stars, 9. And your Centura Centurions, 27.
Welcome to our visiting team, Kearney Catholic, and also to our Centurion fans. Please join us as we glow purple and march for babies around the track. You may have noticed March of Dimes signs as you entered the field tonight, along with some fun extra events too. Centura FBLA is raising awareness for the March of Dimes by painting faces purple to recognize premature babies. The FBLA chapter is also holding a Guess the Senior FBLA Babies contest and selling bubblegum, bubbles for babies, to raise money for the March of Dimes. If you feel led to give as the purple containers go by, know the money given will positively affect the lives of mothers and their babies. For over 84 years, the March of Dimes has helped millions of babies to survive and thrive. For over 50 of those years, Future Business Leaders of America, or FBLA, has been the top youth fundraising partner, raising money for research, education, and awareness. The March of Dimes has impacted our lives in ways many may not even realize. From Apgar newborn screening, surfactant lung therapy, acid intake, kangaroo skin-to-skin holding, to medical training, neonatal intensive care, and education, millions of babies are alive because of the March of Dimes. Please welcome Rebecca Moeller as she shares her NICU experience of just 1 year ago. The care her premature daughter, Natalie, received is due to the March of Dimes.
Hello, my name is Rebecca Moeller, and on this special night, I am here to share our story dealing with the premature delivery. We thought our family was complete, but God thought differently. As an older mom with already high blood pressure, I was listed as high risk from the beginning. After already having 4 kids, I had a feeling we were not going to make it to a full 40 weeks. What I didn't know was how far we were going to miss that mark. But the beginning of the third trimester, my blood pressure was already starting to jump around. We were having trouble getting it to level out even with medication adjustments. August 31st was a good day. I felt good, no swelling, and my blood pressure was excellent. I was even joking around with someone saying I would go early, but not this early. Little did I know how wrong I was. 2:30 the next morning, I had a feeling my water broke. I had no progressing signs of labor, but things felt too much like my third pregnancy that was 5 weeks early to be sure. I called the doctor later that morning. By 11:30 a.m. on September 1, we were at 34 weeks, 6 weeks before a due date, we were being admitted to the hospital. Our baby girl was being a stinker and kept moving away from the monitor. The doctor wanted to get steroids started, hoping to have it in the system for 48 hours. To stabilize the baby's lungs. She was transverse breech, or sideways. We were hoping she would turn on her own. She did, but then she was full breech. Yes, she is a stinker. We made it 48 hours and got the 2 doses of steroids, since nothing was progressing on its own, now a full breech, the decision was made to take the baby C-section. Our Miss Natalie Ann was born September 3rd, 2021 at 1:56 p.m., weighing 4 pounds, 9 ounces, and 17 inches long. After seeing her only moments, she was taken to the NICU for a full assessment. Thankfully, she was breathing on her own with only minimal oxygen mix to help maintain open airways. After delivery, I was taken back to the laboring area to recover, where I began hemorrhaging. After several hours of stabilization, I was taken to my room and finally able to see my tiny baby girl. It wasn't until the next day that I was able to hold her in my arms for the first time. She was in an incubator, had feeding tubes, oxygen tube for forced air, and IV fluids. I had never seen, let alone held, someone so small. I was truly blessed to have the NICU staff to reassure me that things were going to be okay. She was strong and healthy, and now we just needed to keep growing. When feedings are 1 ounce a day and weight is gained in grams, it feels like it takes forever to reach your goal. Feeling very torn between this very vulnerable new life needing me and a family at home needing me, I was not only emotionally, but physically drained. To add to the mess, my hemoglobin numbers were dropping faster than my body could recover. By day two, my hemoglobin levels were 6.4. A normal is 12 to 13, and predicted to drop lower. I was so weak I couldn't get out of bed to go see Natalie. A transfusion was decided as the best course of action. By day four, she was completely off oxygen and taking 3 ounces of milk by feeding tube for the day, and she was almost back to birth weight, but was still in the incubator to keep her body temperature up. On day five, she was now taking part of her feedings by bottle. I was discharged and able to go home to see my kids since they couldn't come to the hospital. As a stay-at-home mom, I'm used to spending a lot of time with my kids, and not having them around was a struggle for me while being away. Although each day she continued to improve, Natalie endured feeding struggles, irregular rhythms of her heart, and issues with breathing control. I divided time between home and hospital, felt guilty about not being able to be with my kids all at once. Natalie finally got her first bath at day 7, weighing 4 pounds, 9.5 ounces, and on day 9, she was taken out of the incubator and holding her own body temperature. This is also making it easier to have video calls with the family who were anxious to meet her at home. By day 16, Natalie is taking all feedings by bottle independently, allowing the feeding tube to be removed. She is now up to 5 pounds, 5.8 ounces, and on day 20, the kids will finally get their chance to meet their new little sister. We are going home. It's a wonderful surprise for them when I pick them up from school that day. Natalie has grown to 5 pounds, 10 ounces. Even though we were thrilled to go home, leaving was bittersweet. We have come to love our nurses who have devoted so much attention to our Natalie. Their experience made a scary situation more bearable. It's hard to think of a time when this would have been a much more uncertain situation. The March of Dimes over the last 80 years has become alongside medical professionals as well as mothers to change the odds for our future. From nutritional needs to newborn screenings, funding research, and making advancements in preterm care, they have benefited not only the babies, but the mothers as well. So tonight, we are showing our support to keep an amazing organization going for many more years so that stories like Natalie's can come into reality for other families. Thanks.
And tonight, for the second act, the marching band presents their field show with the music from Pirates of the Caribbean and Pirates the Caribbean at World's End. Ms. Jordan would like to thank the seniors, Cooper Webb, Blake Suntech, and Will Ford for their dedication and hard work. Congratulations to the band on their parade performances, both receiving superior ratings. Good luck to the band tomorrow as they march their last parade for the season at Minden Band Fest. The Stars started the game receiving the ball. So it's their turn to kick it off to start the second half. Queens' kick returned by Morris, brought down by a constellation of Stars. Centurions will start out 1st and 10. Morris on the carry, tackle made by Homan. 4-yard gain on the play. Morris on the carry, tackle made by Edil. 3rd down for the Centurions. Rule on the keeper, a deal on the tackle. Holding goes against the Centurions. Rule's pass to Morris is complete. The Centurions have it. 4th and 3 to go. Morris's punt is fair caught at the 27-yard line. That's where the Stars will take over, 1st and 10.
That's
Noack on the keeper. Tackle made by Grabowski. 5-yard gain on the play. Trevino on the carry, Melgoza on the tackle. Noack's pass intended for Gaunt falls incomplete. Freeze on the coverage. Brings up 4th and 9 for the Stars. Drumheller's punt, fair caught at the 35-yard line where the Centurions will take over 1st and 10. Morris on the carry, forced out of bounds by Gaunt. 5-yard gain on the play. Morris on the carry, low on the tackle, but not before a Centura first down. Casperson on the carry, Murphy on the tackle, 8-yard gain on the play. Morris on the carry, Redinger on the tackle, flag on the play. Personal foul goes against the Stars. Centurions will have it, first and 10. Morris on the carry, O'Brien on the tackle. Gain of 5 yards on the play. Fanta's pass intended for Freeze falls incomplete. Morris on the carry, Holman on the tackle, but not before a Centura first down. And the Stars recover the fumble. Kearney Catholic will start out first and 10 from the 25-yard line. Noack's pass intended for Lowe falls incomplete. Flag on the play. Pass interference goes against the Centurions. The Stars will have it, first and 10. Ravener on the carry, Grabowski on the tackle. Gain of 9 yards on the play. Redinger on the carry, tackle in the backfield made by Malgoza. Loss of 2 yards on the play. Remaining. After the timeout, it's Kearney Catholic's ball, 3rd and 2. Penalty goes against the Centurions. The Stars will have the first down. Redinger on the carry, holding on the play. The Stars will have it, 1st and 20. Noack's pass to Gunt is complete. Caden Rule on the tackle. Loss of 5 yards on the play. Redinger on the carry, Kasperson and Garcia on the tackle. Third down for Kearney Catholic. Noach's pass is complete, tackled by a host of Centurions. Brings up fourth down. Drumheller's punt, they're caught by Morris. Flag on the flag. Personal foul goes against the Centurions. They'll start out first and 10 from the 15-yard line. Morris on the carry, Murphy forcing him out of bounds, but not before a Centura first down. Rule's pass is intercepted by Lowe. Kearney Catholic takes over first and 10 from the 48-yard line. Redinger on the carry, Garcia on the tackle. Gain of 3 yards on the play. Redinger on the carry, tackle on the play by Casperson. And that'll be the end of the third quarter, where your score here tonight is the Kearney Catholic Stars 9 and your Centura Centurions 27. Start the ball, Kearney Catholic. To start the fourth quarter, Kearney Catholic has the ball. Third and 3. Penalty goes against the Stars. 5-yard penalty will make it 3rd and 8. Gaunt on the carry, tackle in the backfield by Melgoza. Loss of 5 on the play. Drumheller's punt is downed at the 36-yard line. That's where the Centurions will start out, first and 10. Morris on the carry, tackle made by Homan. Second and 9 for the Centurions. Morris on the carry, forced out of bounds by Wimhoff. But not before a Centura first down. Casperson on the carry, Gaunt on the tackle, flag on the play. Personal foul goes against the Stars. Be a 15-yard penalty. Casperson on the carry, Rogish on the tackle, gain of a yard on the play. Morris on the carry, Gaunt on the tackle. Gain of 6 yards on the play. Thank you. Morris on the carry, Ragish on the tackle. Fourth and one for Centura. Centura will take a timeout. That is their first timeout of the half, and they'll have two remaining.
Thank you to everyone who participated in the March of Dimes walk and to everyone who donated. It really means a lot. Our winner of the senior baby guessing game is Emma Parr with 7 correct answers. We also exceeded our goal of $100, and we got $187.45. Thank you again to everyone who donated. Emma Parr, please find Hope McDonald for your prize. Thank you.
Coming out of the timeout, Centura has it, 4th and 1 from the 26-yard line. Morris on the carry, Gaunt on the tackle, but not before a Centura first down. Flag on the play. Penalty goes against the Centurions. It'll be 5 yards, making it 1st and 15. Morris on the carry, Arlen on the tackle. Thank you. Kasperson on the carry, Crone on the tackle. Third and six for Centura. Flag on the play. Penalty goes against the Centurions. The third and 10. Centura will take a timeout. That is their second timeout of the half, and they will have one remaining. Rule on the keeper, Redinger on the tackle. Fourth down for the Centurions. Kasperson on the carry, Crone on the tackle, but not before a Centura first down. Kasperson on the carry, Arlt on the tackle. Second and goal for the Centurions. Kasperson on the carry. Tackle made by O'Brien. Third and goal for Centura. Kasperson's carry just short of the goal line brings up a fourth and goal for the Centurions. And that's Boston Kasperson for another Centura touchdown. And the point after is no good. With 1 minute and 50 seconds remaining in the game, your score is the Kearney Catholic Stars 9 and your Centura Centurions 33. Freeze's kick returned by David. Tackle on the play by Grabowski. The Stars will start out first and 10 from the 24-yard line. Noack's pass falls incomplete. Brings up second down for the Stars. Hey! No Axe pass to Lowe is complete and good for a Kearney Catholic touchdown. Murphy on the hold, Weems on the kick is good. With a minute 24 remaining in the game, your score is the Kearney Catholic Stars 16 and your Centura Centurions 33. Weems' kick, fair caught by Freeze. Centura will take over first and 10 at the 38-yard line. Rules pass to Garcia is complete. Flag on the play. Penalty goes against the Centurions. it's Rule who will take a knee. As the time is winding down on this game, your final score tonight will be the Kearney Catholic Stars 16 and your Centura Centurions 33.